Well, it has been a very long time since I made a video on this channel, and you're completely forgiven if you've completely forgotten who I am. In fact, I'm not sure who I am. Mate, you're ClimateAdam. You're a doctor in climate science, but you spend most of your time making YouTube videos about climate change. Oh yeah, that sounds about right. Thanks, Adam. No problem, Adam. Well, since I last spoke on this channel, there have been two very important numbers. The first is just a very important number to me, and the number is 100,000. So I hit 100,000 views on this channel, and that's not a huge amount for a YouTube channel, but it is a huge amount considering what I initially expected. It's about 100,000 times bigger than I ever thought I'd achieve. So thank you so much for watching all my videos in the past. And if you haven't already, please do make sure to subscribe because it makes just the biggest difference in the world. Okay, but now for a number that affects more people in the world than just me. And that number is 1.5. To be specific, it's 1.5 degrees of global warming since pre-industrial temperatures. And this temperature, this amount of warming, is what the world agreed in Paris to aim to limit global warming to. And I made a video about Paris before. You can watch it. I'm sure I'll put a link somewhere around. And this limit really took the climate science community by surprise. We really hadn't thought about it that much. There was very little research on what it would take to limit warming to 1.5 degrees or what the benefits and costs of limiting warming to 1.5 degrees would be. So in the last few years, the IPCC, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, has put together this big, important report on this magical 1.5 degree temperature. So now we have a much better idea of what that is. And that report comes out today, the 8th of November, 2018. So now we have no excuse. We can have a look at what it means to limit the world's warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius. So what do we know? Okay, well, firstly, it might not sound like a big number, but there would be some big consequences. We're talking about massive reductions in the number of heat waves, flooding, droughts that the world could experience. These kinds of extreme weather events wreak havoc, as we know, just from looking at what's been happening this last year in 2018. It wouldn't just be extreme weather events that we'd be better protected from. Millions of people around the world would be at much lower risk of food scarcity and water scarcity. And you know, like, food and water are pretty important things to live from. So because of this, if we limited warming to 1.5 degrees, there'd be a lot lower risk of climate poverty. It's not just people who would be helped by limiting the world's warming to 1.5 degrees. It's also the world's ecosystems. So insects would be hugely better off in a world in which we limited warming to 1.5 degrees. You might hate insects, but insects are pretty fundamental to how plants grow. They're also really fundamental to ecosystems in general. So protecting insects is quite important. We don't want to just kill them all off. It's not just insects as well, it's also beautiful coral reefs, which at higher levels of warming might be virtually wiped out by climate change. But at 1.5 degrees, we could expect to be relatively protected. Okay, so it's pretty clear that this temperature limit that surprised scientists has some pretty big benefits. But what would it actually take to get there? Well, to stop global warming at all, we know what we need to do. We need to stop emitting greenhouse gases, most importantly, carbon dioxide. Okay, but what if we want to limit warming specifically to 1.5 degrees? Well, then we need to stop emitting carbon dioxide really soon. Like, really soon. So the world has already warmed by about 1 degree Celsius, so we've got only 0.5 degree left. It looks like we probably need global emissions to get to zero by about 2050. To put that in context, when my new niece is about my age, the world's emissions will need to be about zero. So we need to get from a world where our economy completely depends on fossil fuels to a world where it doesn't depend on them at all. But that's not all. It looks likely that it's not enough just to get emissions to zero. We also need to employ negative emissions. Now, negative emissions are just a fancy way of saying we need to suck carbon dioxide out of the air. That is an incredibly difficult thing to do. We don't really know whether we can do it or what the consequences of doing it at the scales we would like to do it are. But it might be required if we are going to limit warming to 1.5 degrees. Oh my God, I could talk about this for absolute ages, and I have talked about this for absolute ages. You can see a video of mine about negative emissions I made before, and I put loads of links in the description to other videos and articles you can read about 1.5 degrees, about climate change in general. But I would like to talk to you now about how I feel when I read about 1.5 degrees. And it's a mixture of feelings, to be honest. The first thing I feel is, oh my God, it would be incredible and so important for our planet if we could limit global warming to 1.5 degrees. And the second thing I feel is that the world isn't heading there. If we look at what's happening to global emissions, they're not falling rapidly and dramatically like they need to soon. They are going up. We're heading in literally the opposite direction to where we need to go. But don't just go away. The important thing to say is that if we miss 1.5 degrees of warming, it's not game over. It's not like climate change wins if we miss 1.5 degrees. We may be committing ourselves to a more dangerous future, but say 2 degrees is still much better than 3 degrees of warming, and 3 degrees of warming is still much better than 4. So if we miss this target, it's not like we can just give up. We need to fight just as hard as we always should have been fighting to try and limit global warming as quickly as possible. And that means cutting our emissions, both as individuals and as a society, as rapidly as we possibly can. But let's be realistic. A lot of this is just my perspective and how I personally feel when I think about the consequences and the difficulties of getting to 1.5 degrees. And I would love to know if you think I'm wrong in this, if you think it's really useful to have a target, an ambitious target like 1.5 degrees to aim for, or you think it is definitely possible that we can do it, we just need to get our acts together, or you think we should have been having this conversation about 10 years ago. Actually, on that last point, I think we would definitely agree. It is incredible to be back and making videos about climate change again, and there will be a lot of new videos coming out very soon. There's one in particular coming out in the next week that I do not want you to miss. So please make sure you're subscribed, and while you're here, check out a recent-ish video over here. Until next time, bye.